Good evening, sports fans. I'm Chuck Burgess.
I'm Nick Mooney. How's it going? First of all, I'd like to get out of the way that the only reason I'm wearing a 49ers shirt this week is because there isn't one that has Jerry Rice's name on the back that doesn't have it, unfortunately. So I don't want there to be any confusion.
There's not like a Raiders or something?
No, there's not a Raiders, and I would actually rather wear a 49ers. Every week is Halloween at Raiders Stadium.
Yeah. All right.
All right, we got some good topics. We got some more subscribers. We thank everyone who's been subscribing. We got some great topics coming up this week, so let's get right down to them.
Looks like we're going to start with the old Major League Baseball and all of the hype going on about the little injections and things people are doing.
Yep, 20 people, right? 20 people or more after the All-Star break to be, and now those big names obviously.
To be investigated for possible bans, and the bans they said could go up to as much as 100 games. So it's a serious suspension.
So, and those two big players are, of course, Ryan Braun and Alex Rodriguez. Both of those guys have been known for, you know, and have been suspected of using them for years. You know, they've tested positive a couple times. What do you think the punishment should be for this?
Well, first of all, the players' union says that the players want the game to be a clean game. They want the players to be clean. Mm-hmm. And the owners say that they want it to be a clean game.
Yeah. Which would institute it being a clean game if that's what everyone wants.
Right. Which makes me wonder what the managers and the coaches want. Because apparently... The owners and the players got something going on, and the other guys are saying, nope, go juice up. The thing is that you do the crime, you do the time. Whatever they decide, if you don't want to be suspended for 100 games, don't juice. Go by the, you know, do it naturally. That's it.
Yeah. You know? So, I mean, the thing is, hard work will always beat anything else. You can never take the cheap way out. I think that's great advice for anyone who's trying to play these games. I know that people are getting better and people have, you know, positions. And, you know, it's just about hard work, I think.
Yeah.
So do you think, I mean, if these guys, some of these guys are getting caught, you know, this is their second time getting caught. So do you think, you know, after a certain amount of time, should you be banned from the game if you get caught enough times?
I think the suspension should get worse and worse. And, yeah, eventually if you can't seem to play by the rules, you know, there's three strikes and you're out in life. You know, you get three major felonies.
Yeah,
you're going away for life.
There's three strikes in baseball.
You know, there's three strikes in baseball. They might as well make it three strikes. So if you're banned or if you are suspended three times for the same offense, you know, maybe you ought to go look for another career.
Absolutely. I would agree with that completely. Okay.
So the other one would it be...
Oh, so today. This actually happened today. We just learned about this. But the Detroit Tigers and the White Sox got into a feud.
Pitchers had some wild pitches.
Yeah, and we've talked about this before, so we won't go too much into it. But it was kind of funny. What did you think of Torrey Hunter's comments after the game?
If you haven't seen it, look it up.
Look it up.
It's actually very comical.
It's, you know, he handled that such a great way.
Yes, he did. He refused to comment about any negative or derogatory things.
But he used his eyes enough to kind of let you know.
It was fun.
It was a good time. So, I mean, now, with all these bench-clearing brawls and everything, here's another thing I thought was really interesting. Jim Leland went out there three different times. He got thrown out
of the game.
And then went back two other times to argue, should he get a fine for that?
If you're... You know, kicked out of a game and you're told to leave, you need to leave. And if you don't, there should be a penalty for that.
Yeah.
Well, whether it be, you didn't listen last time, so you're going to have to completely miss a game. You know, whatever. Yeah. Something needs to be done so that he understands that the umpires, believe it or not, are in charge of the game and have, you know, last say.
Here's my thing. If you're going to argue something, don't get me wrong, you know, players and fans love it when coaches argue. You know, there's nothing wrong with that. It's just that you have to do it in a way that's not disobeying what they're saying. You know, you get thrown out of the game, then you need to leave, you know. Right. And if you come back the first time, then you get a warning. But that second time, him coming back.
And the third time.
I'm sure he still had plenty more to say.
And that's fine. You know, after the game, he can, you know, find it up and say whatever he needs to say or whatever.
Or just say everything out there before you leave, you know. I mean,
or tweet
get it all out there.
Or tweet it. We would all love to hear what you have to say. Tweet us.
Yeah. Absolutely. So a weird situation there.
Yep. So let's go to the NBA.
Let's do it. Yeah, let's do it. There's a couple big signings and some weird stuff going on. First of all, I guess we'll talk about the big thing, which is Dwight Howard decides to go to the Rockets. He decides to opt out of the L.A. Spotlight. He wants to go somewhere where, you know,
he's playing with James Harden.
Yep. So do you think he couldn't handle being a Laker? I mean, it's a big responsibility. Do you think that had to do with it, or?
No. I think he's a professional. I like Dwight Howard. His defense is, you know,
one of the best in the game.
Just outstanding. Mm-hmm. And I think he's a true pro. I think he wants a team to be built around him. Mm-hmm. And the Lakers have Kobe. You know, the team's built kind of around Kobe. Mm-hmm. And I think I think there are teams in the NBA where he could be the head honcho, the one that they build around. Mm-hmm. The Lakers isn't one of them.
Well, here's my problem is Dwight Howard was in a system where he was the head honcho. He was in Orlando, and they went to a finals, and they lost. And my thing is, you know, for years now, it's been Dwight Howard saying, well, I want to go somewhere where I can win a championship. That's what I want to do and win a championship. You cannot have both of those mentalities. You know, it's like LeBron James. LeBron James had the option of staying in Cleveland and being the main focal point of that team, or going and pairing up with Dwayne Wade and Chris Bosh and winning championships. He chose that. There's no both. And Dwight Howard wants both. He wants his cake, and he wants to be able to eat it too.
Yeah.
He wants to go and be the focal point of this team and then just win like seven in a row. And what he doesn't realize is that although he's good, he's not that good.
No, I agree.
So, the thing is, being with the Lakers, you know, the Lakers are always going to find a way to win. They're one of the great, you know, 16 championships. Being with them, even though I can totally understand it, Kobe's only got 2 or 3 years left at most.
I really think the Rockets, with Dwight Howard and James Harden and the distance shooters that they have, I think they've got a shot at, you know, getting in for the next 4 or 5 years.
I think they have a shot of getting into the playoffs for the next four or five years, which they've already done that. So, I mean,
I think they'll maintain it. I think, you know, Howard's going to have his chance to see if, you know, to show, hey, I can lead these two to a championship. And good luck to him.
We'll see. The other thing was the Rockets actually got fined $150,000 because they spoke of that matter too soon. They're not supposed to. They knew they weren't supposed to.
July 10th was the beginner. Before you can't say anything before July 10th about who's signing with you and who's not. And apparently they let it slip that that Dwight Howard was going to sign with them before the contract was announced, or before the legal time to announce the contract. They fined him $150,000. They need to shut up and pay it. They knew the rules. You break the rules. You know, it's
a fair fine. You don't think it's too much?
Well, I think it's ridiculous, but
that's coming from us, though. We don't make $150,000. They make $150,000.
In a second.
They just made it right now. So,
but rules are rules.
Yeah, that's true.
And I'm a guy that believes in the rules. You know, I mean, if you don't like the rule, then change the rule.
Or if you don't like the rule, then don't be an NBA owner and you can go work at McDonald's and, you know, make minimum wage like, you know, a lot of us.
Yeah.
All right. Any more? Oh, yeah. Hey, we have Andrew Bynum, actually. I think this is a funny story. Andrew Bynum, he played with the Lakers a couple years ago. He hyperextended his knee. He's a kind of an arrogant guy. I don't mean to say that, but he is. He gets traded to Philadelphia and then doesn't play a single game with them. So Philadelphia says, well, we don't want you anymore. You know, your knee's kind of shot. So the Cavaliers signed him to a 2-year, $24 million deal. Now my question is, how can you sign someone for that much money who hasn't played in a year and a half and who has that much injury problem? Why is something that someone did 2 or 3 years ago worth that much money now?
When this was a topic that Nick put on here, I didn't have prior knowledge of it. I did go research it. And what I did find out was that Bynum's only guaranteed $6 million over 2 years. Mm-hmm. So it is a performance-induced contract. If he doesn't perform, the $24 million's not going to be there. Well, and the club has the option on the second year, not Bynum.
Okay. Well, so I agree with that.
That makes a little bit of a difference, but that's still $6 million. That's an investment in a guy that if his knee doesn't hold up, and they said it's an injury similar to Kobe's, and he went to Germany, but all the report I saw, there was an insider saying that the knee doesn't look like it's going to hold up, that it is deteriorating and will never be as good as it was last year, and will continue to get worse, that he might have bursts of greatness, but they'll be short. It's not... But here's the thing, though.
When you say performance evaluate, do you mean like he has to hit a certain number of stats, or do you just mean he has to play? Because if he has to play, I mean, he could play like crap. I mean, he could go out there and play, and then you never get a rebound and everything, and you still have to pay him the $24 million. So that's...
But if he's playing like crap, are you going to play? That's the thing.
Well, but that's their decision, though. That wouldn't be invalidated in the...
Well, that's... That's their decision, exactly.
Yeah, so they're still going to have to pay him. And I just, So I think that's a risk. It's a risk.
It's a big risk.
But I guess, you know, in all honesty, if you're the Cavaliers, what do you have to lose at this point? You've been dead last 2 years in a row now, so you know, give it your all. You had the first pick, so we'll see.
Let's go to the NFL. All right. Let's talk about the Patriots. Let's talk about something down that happened to the Patriots again. For the second time in 15 days, the Patriots have probably or possibly lost another player. Mm-hmm. Alphonso Dinard, their cornerback, was arrested for DUI. He was already on probation for assault on a police officer. He had still owed the court system 30 days in jail, a 30-day sentence. This newest DUI could be real bad news for him, because his probation was to be perfect. You know, don't screw up, and he did. The Patriots had warned him, don't screw up, and he did. What's going to happen? I don't know. The Patriots don't know. They're wanting more information.
They're probably going to lose a cornerback.
I would say they may lose a cornerback. I think this is his second year.
He's a young kid. Here's the thing. We talk about the Pacers. We've talked about them like 5 weeks in a row now, you know, and it's not that we mean to. It's just that bad stuff keeps happening to them. At this point, have the Patriots almost hit rock bottom for this season? I mean, could you just say that you just scraped the season and you think they still have a chance?
Well, I don't know about that, but rock bottom?
Well, no,
they could lose a few more players. Well, you know, Tom Brady could go out in the first game and break his leg.
That's true, but when you're talking about rock bottom...
Tim Tebow would be their... we're at rock bottom.
No. But when you're talking about rock bottom, though, for the Patriots, these Patriots are expecting an 11-5 season. They're expecting a Super Bowl. That's what the Patriots fans expect every year.
Right. Well, 11-5, I think, is very optimistic. I think if they get to eight and eight, that's a damn good season for them this year.
Yeah. Okay.
I think they're gonna. It's a stretch to get to 8-8, but we'll see. We'll see.
All right, so next thing we're going to talk about, I guess, would be the Matt Stafford contract extension. He gets a 3-year,
$53 million.
I was kind of surprised it wasn't longer. I thought, you know, most people are getting a lot longer contracts, but I guess because he's
29?
Yeah.
So he's entering his prime. I mean, you know, the guy's, he's good for at least another 6 or 7 years, you'd think. Mm-hmm. So I'm not sure why such a short contract. I guess they wanted to lock him in, I guess, before he gets too expensive, which $53 million sounds kind of expensive.
It is kind of expensive. Well, that's like $16, $17 million a year when you add it out. So.
Yeah, almost 18. And here's my homework I did. Joe Flacco makes $20 million a year, roughly. Mm-hmm. Drew Brees makes $20 million a year. Aaron Rodgers makes about $18.7 million a year. Mm-hmm. And he had the highest passer rating for a quarterback last year of 108. Mm-hmm. Matt Stafford got his $18 million a year contract. Tony Romo, $17 million a year. Peyton Manning, $15 million a year. And he was the number two in passer rating with a 105.8 rating. Eli, $15 million a year. So he's like, hey, big brother, look, I'm making as much as you. RG3, getting down to the rookies now. I didn't put everybody in. I just put... what I consider, you know, stepping stones. RG3, $4.8 million a year, and he was the third highest passer rating this year with 102.4. Just to let you know, some of the other guys in the NFL, Colin Kaepernick will get $1.3 million this year and $1.6 million next year.
Chump change.
Russell Wilson, who was the fourth on the list of passer ratings with a 100, is making $817,000 a year on average for the next 3 years.
Money!
I don't know. But to me, I think I would exchange the Romo $17 million for the 8-17 with Russell Wilson just about any day of the week to get a passer that throws a passer rating of 100 versus a guy that is getting $17 million and
going to the main thing though, we're talking about Matthew Stafford here, he got
$18 million, and I think this year is going to be his standout year. I think he's going to stand up, and this is going to be the year that people say, hey, look at the Lions go.
Well, I mean, he threw for 5,000 yards last year. So, I mean, that's that. He
but there has been other areas of the Lions game that has been tremendously flawed.
Yeah.
You can throw for 5,000 yards. If your defense allows 7,000 yards, then you're screwed.
Yeah, but that's why he deserves that money. Though, because 5,000 yards.
5,000 yards is a lot of yards.
He definitely
to throw.
Needs to tone up the interception rate, though. I mean, he's got many things, and he doesn't have anybody to throw to either. So, I mean, except Calvin Johnson, of course. Yeah, you know, one guy. So, I mean, it really is. I think that, you know, him getting that money is standard. I think it's kind of ridiculous, some of those guys, because you were mentioning, like, Romo does not deserve that money. The only reason Flacco got that money is because he won the Super Bowl.
Yeah.
And then you look at...
he's not worth $20 million a year.
Breeze, I can understand that.
In my opinion, they're, you know...
Mm-hmm. So, I mean, and you know, you got Peyton Manning only making $15 million. So, I mean, I just think that
you know, maybe the Russell Wilsons of the world maybe they deserve $1.5 million, and maybe the Flaccos of the world only deserve like $14 million. You know, even it out a little bit, because Flacco he's not the Ravens team. He's one guy on the Ravens team.
Yeah, absolutely. You've got Ray Rice, and you've got amazing defense.
I mean, you could put another quarterback in the Ravens, and you could still have a Super Bowl quality team.
Absolutely.
Because it's the team that took them there.
Absolutely.
You know, there's other teams where it's not so much. You know, Aaron Rodgers is a huge part.
Yeah, absolutely. If anyone deserves that money, he does.
I thought it was kind of interesting that some of the players that are making the most money have passer ratings that aren't so good. Mm-hmm. And then you've got other guys that are making no money that their passer ratings are way up there.
Yeah. So, well, and it's not a stat thing. It's about who, you know, you could bring someone like Romo, obviously, you know, who has won one playoff game. He somehow got that money. And you look at people
like...
A great agent. Yeah.
I mean, you
look at people like Flacco, who, you know, he's been an okay quarterback for many years. And then this year, his team
he's good.
Was
he's
good.
A good.
He's a good quarterback. Does he deserve to be the number one?
Is he a great Hall of Famer? No.
No, not yet. He doesn't deserve that money yet. So it's kind of a weird deal. But so fair enough. You know, I think Matthew Stafford got kind of what he deserved. Especially being that short. I kind of don't like all the 7-year contracts just because you're putting a lot of faith in someone. So, you know, 3 years I think was respectable. So hopefully the Lions can tone it back up. But we'll see.
Well, and in 3 years he's going to make a payday. Either he's going to pan out and make a payday in 3 years. And it may have been him that was requesting the 3 years, because he may, you know.
Well, you look at, I'm sure Calvin, you got to understand, you know, too, he has Calvin Johnson to throw to. You know, 2,000 yards alone to Calvin Johnson. So
you got two more receivers like that, buddy. You got to make 6,000 a year.
Put Jerry Rice on the other side.
Yeah, there you go.
So, all right, well, is that all we have to talk about
today? I think that's it, man. That was a mouthful, wasn't it?
Yeah, it was. All right, well, once again, thank you all for watching. Feel free to send us any topics you'd like to hear about, and we'll gladly look them up and talk about them.
You betcha.
I will go ahead and announce that we are pretty soon going to be doing another special. It's going to be fantasy football. We're going to go position by position and do some fantasy football things, so I know that's a big deal coming up, so be sure to check those out.
I like fantasy football.
Fantasy football is a lot of fun.
I've been playing since 95, 94, somewhere around in there.
And I've been born since 92. So,
yeah,
long time.
Almost as long as he's been born.
Yep, long time.
So I still suck at it, but I play.
Yeah, it's it's a hard sport. I hate fantasy. Gridlock. Anyway, see you next week.
See ya.